Good morning, Eisenhower. I'm your host, Laura, along with
Maria. Today is Tuesday, November 5th, Davy.
Today in history, on November 5th, 1950, during the Korean War, British and Australian forces successfully halted the advancing Chinese during the Battle of Pakon.
Please rise for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You may be seated.
And now for today's announcements with Greg
and Raylene.
Good morning. I'm Greg, along with
Raylene.
What does today's weather look like?
Today will be partly cloudy with a high of 50. Tuesday night will be partly cloudy with a low of 39. Wednesday will be mostly cloudy with a high of 59. Now here's Greg with today's announcements.
Thank you, Raylene. There will be a meeting for all girls interested in trying out for basketball on Thursday, November 14th. The meeting will be from 3 o'clock to 3:15 in room 415. Please see Ms. Laverty if you cannot attend. Attention, all 8th grade students interested in hearing more information about the university programs being offered at the high schools. The supervisors of the university programs will be visiting Eisenhower on Wednesday, November 13th, during 8th grade lunch. There will be 3 different presentations, one for each university program. You need to sign up in your homeroom if you would like to attend one of the sessions. Also, you will need to bring your lunch from home on that day because the presentations will begin at 11:55. Attention, all creative writers of Eisenhower School. Barbara, the teen librarian, will be hosting her teen writers group this Wednesday from 4 o'clock to 5:30 in the Monroe Room of the library. Bring something you have written to share with the group, please. Anyone who knows Barbara knows there will be snacks worth eating and lots of fun. Contact her as soon as possible if you're interested in attending. There will be no general react meeting on Wednesday. Only REACT officers should meet in Ms. Moser's room after school on Wednesday to plan the next couple of months. The girls and boys soccer party will be today right after school in the gym. Make sure to bring your uniform to the party. Here's Raylene with the rest of the day's announcements.
Thank you, Greg. There's no math club this week. We will meet again next Wednesday. The student council will not be meeting this week. We will have a meeting next Tuesday in the cafeteria. Homeroom reps, please remember to bring in boxes for the food drive that runs from November 11th to 22nd. There is no Brain Busters meeting this Wednesday. Reminder, if you are nominated for the advisory council, please be sure to turn in your permission slip to the guidance office. Students are not allowed in the building in the morning to decorate lockers. If you want to decorate a locker for a friend's birthday, you can do it after school. Is Eisenhower celebrating any birthdays today?
Eisenhower wishes a very happy birthday to Mei Lu in 7C, Aaron in 8C, and Ava in 6C. What's for lunch today?
Today's lunch is baked chicken with broccoli and rice. What's tomorrow's lunch?
Tomorrow's lunch is Wild Wing Wednesday. What's in the headlines?
Democrats and unions have spent more than $35 million in New Jersey trying to prevent any shifts in the legislature that would give Governor Christie more power.
And now for today's feature with Dean
and Connor.
Good morning, Eisenhower. Today we have Stephanie from Student Council.
How are you, Stephanie?
Good, how are you?
I'm good.
What has been happening in Student Council so far this year?
We have been having a great year so far. We just finished up with our cookie sales, and some of us recently went to a leadership conference at the College of New Jersey. We are in the process of selecting students to be members at large and are now working on our next big project, the food drive.
And what exactly is the food drive?
The Student Council has run a food drive every year. It will begin next week from the 11th, and the Student Council will organize the food after school on November 22nd. The food from our event will be donated to the Ridgewood Social Service Association Food Pantry, which helps to feed those in need in our area.
What can students bring in?
Each homeroom will receive a list of non-perishable box and canned goods that can be brought in by a student. Our goal is for each homeroom to bring in 50 items, which is about 2 items per person. The items on the list are mostly things that you would typically see at a Thanksgiving dinner, but you are welcome to bring in any non-perishable items that are listed.
And will there be a contest?
Yes, we're going to have a contest this year. The homeroom who donates the most food to the food drive in each grade will receive a donut party.
Thank you, Stephanie.
Thank you.
Tomorrow's feature is homework.
Now, back to our host,
Laura
and Maria.
Thanks, Connor and Dean, and now for the joke of the day.
What time does an oak get up?
What?
At 3 o'clock.
Thanks for watching Eisenhower. Have a Gossip Girl, What Would Blair Waldorf Do Tuesday?